So if you're new to Mac, you may not yet be familiar with how scroll bars work on Macs. So, for instance, here I am in macOS High Sierra and I have a Pages document. And you can obviously see it fills more than just what I can see here on the screen. So I need to scroll up. Now there's no scroll bar on the right like you may be used to from years ago using Windows or a much older version of macOS. But you can use either the trackpad with two fingers or your mouse with one finger to scroll. So I'm going to use on my Magic Mouse here one finger to scroll up. So I'm just swiping from the bottom to the top to scroll up, from the top to the bottom to scroll down. The same thing on the trackpad but with two fingers. So that's how I can scroll and I don't even have to worry about the existence of the scroll bar. But notice that when I did that, the scroll bar appears on the right and as long as I keep scrolling up and down, I'll see that scroll bar there. Now as soon as I stop, it fades away. But if while I'm scrolling I move my mouse over to that scroll bar, it not only stays but it gets a little bit larger so I can click on it. And now I can use it like I could have used a scroll bar in years past. I can click and drag up and down. I can click below it to jump, above it to jump. So the scroll bars work just like they did before, except now if I move away it will fade and go away again. So it doesn't get in the way when you don't need it, and when you do need it, it does appear. So it's a little bit of scrolling and then you move over and now you can select it. Now this works the same way in other apps as well. So for instance, even in the Finder here, here's a Finder window with a list of files. There's no scroll bar on the right, but if I use my mouse with one finger to swipe up and down or my trackpad with two fingers up and down, I can see the scroll bar there. If I move my cursor over to it, it enlarges and I can drag it just like a scroll bar in the past. You control a lot of these options using System Preferences. So in System Preferences under Mouse, for instance, it'll show you, if I move my cursor over scroll direction, it'll show you a little animation over here of what it's like to scroll with a Magic Mouse. If I go to the trackpad and I go to scroll and zoom, I can also see here a little animation of using two fingers to scroll up and down. Now notice both had an option to change the scroll direction from natural to the other way. The other way actually reverses it, which seems odd to me now, but for years and years both Mac and Windows kind of did the scroll bar in the reverse direction to the natural way and a lot of us got used to it. So you could always turn off the natural direction movement if you find the things are happening in reverse. I recommend you don't do this though, but get used to having the scroll bars working the natural way, because not only is it how all Macs work, so if you go to another Mac you'll be used to using scrolling that way, but also it is more in sync with how we use touch devices like the iPhone and the iPad. So your brain's basically thinking in the same direction using natural here on the Mac as it would say on an iPad or an iPhone. Now there's some other options in System Preferences you should know about, and you can get to those by going to General. And under General you've got Show Scroll Bars. And you can see now it's set to how all Macs are by default, automatically based on mouse or trackpad, which is what we've seen. However, we can also switch to Always, which will return the scroll bars to what you might be used to always having them there. And now you can move and get them whenever you want. And you also can use the scroll bars as a measure of how far you are in the document. So I can see here I'm like in the middle of the document. Here I'm at the top of the document. You also have the ability to do it when scrolling. So what does this mean? Well, obviously we saw it before when scrolling. But now also whenever you're actually moving the page. So I have my cursor down here. I'm going to down arrow. And you can see since by using the down arrow I'm scrolling the document, the scroll bar appears on the right. That's great because it gives you a visual cue as to where you are in the document. So you go into System Preferences and modify these when you want. My recommendation is to try to leave it on the default so you're used to using it on any Mac. Perhaps turn on when scrolling if you find you do a lot of work in documents where you really want to see where you are in the document. And only use Always if you are really having a lot of trouble dealing with not having the scroll bars there when you want them.